Okay, in this project we have these CAD files and we are going to import them in our Revit file to use them as a reference to model our projects. And also I'm going to tell you 5 or 6 tips about optimizing the CAD files or DWG files before importing them to Revit. The first one is when you have different plans, the first step you should save each plan in a separate file. For example, for the ground floor, I need to select this and press Ctrl C and create a new file from here and press Ctrl V and save it in a new DWG file. Okay. The coordination is not really important for me because it's a small project and I can align the project according to the walls and according to the grids. Just press Ctrl S and save this project, save this plan as a, for example, plan 1 on your desktop, and also you can get access to all of our exercise files in our Patreon that I have put a link in the description. Be sure to check it. Okay, save this file, save this plan as a plan 1. And for the second floor, you need to do the same process again. Select all of the elements from here. Maybe this kind of selecting is more appropriate for this kind of things. And then press Ctrl C, click here and create a new DWG file. Press Ctrl V and put it everywhere you want. But be careful that your DWG file doesn't have any kind of Z properties, because it will be not really good when you have Z coordinates in your Revit file, especially if you are working with plans. If it's about working with contours or something that are usually with Z coordinates, it's fine. But if you have plans, make sure that you have no points or line in Z coordinates and with any Z coordinates above the 0. Okay, that's nice for me. Press Ctrl S and save it. Let me name it Plan 2 and save it. But the other tips before exporting them, let me open both of them. Let me open both of the plans, Plan 1 and Plan 2. And I have some tips before exporting or before importing. Open plan 1, open plan 2. The AutoCAD files is a killer for your Revit file optimization. So, beside that, you should control the amount of CAD files you are importing in your Revit file. You need to do some other kind of things to optimize your DWG files before importing. The first one is the overkill tool that will delete your duplicate objects and delete the lines with overlapping and make your files very lighter. Let me go to the plan 1 and type overkill tool and then select all of the objects and press enter. Now you can click on OK, and now you can see this tool has deleted about 56 overlap line for my project. It is a big number, so it is very nice. And the second tool you need to use before importing the CAD files in your Revit is purge unused things. Again, type purge here and click on purge. And from here, check all of the items and press the purge all button here. Purge all checked items. click again until the bottom is grayed out. Okay, click on close. We don't need these things anymore, so it is an optimized file for our importing. But another tip that I'm going to tell you is that if you don't need any hatches or if you don't need any furniture, please delete them first, because they make your Revit files very slow. If you don't need any hatches, please delete them in your Revit file. Okay. And also the last thing is you need to make sure that your layers are with name conventions, because if you have some layers with right names, you can adjust the color, weight, and other kind of properties of them in your Revit files too. So it will help you to work properly and work fast. You need to do the same processes for plan 2 again, but I'm not going to do that again, but you need to do this process for all of your CAD files. Let me close it and click on yes and save the files, and we don't need to our AutoCAD software anymore. Let me minimize it and let's go to the Revit file. Let me create a new file in my AutoCAD. Oh, I'm going to create a file according to metric architectural template and click on OK. As you know, we have two ways to import or other kind of importing CAD files in our Revit. We have linked files, and we have a way that called link, and another way is importing. When you have some workflow between your CAD and between your Revit that the CAD files are going to change frequently, you need to use a link CAD. But if you are sure that there wouldn't be any change in your CAD files, you can use import CAD. The import CAD option will give you more setting and will give you more freedom to change the properties. Okay, click on import CAD and select your, when you are in level 1, select your plan 1 and import that in this view. Okay, select the plan 1, and there are some options that I'm going to describe them to you now. The first one is current view only checkbox. If you check that, the plan 1 is just going to import in your level 1. But if you wouldn't check that, it will be visible in your 3D view too. For the first one, we need to imported our CAD files in 3D and in 2D and other kind of views. But for the others, we don't need that, because when we are importing that in all of our views, we can use them as a reference for aligning our files. Okay, this is good for me. The colors are not very important, but if you want to preserve the colors of your AutoCAD files, you need to set it on preserve, and or if you want to make them black and white, you can select black and white. I'm going to use preserve, and after that I'm going to use manual origin and place this file at level 1. Okay, we don't need any other kind of adjustment. But before that, let me say one thing about import unit. If you know the exact unit of the file, you can check, you can select the exact unit and equal unit to your AutoCAD file. But if you don't, you just need to adjust on one of them, and then you can scale it according to the dimensions or according to the dimensions, according to the standards. Okay, and let me put it on meter and click on open. I'm just placing everywhere I want. It's not very important because I'm going to align it with other plans, and also I'm going to scale it properly. Click here and your CAD files will be here. For example, according to the dimensions, I know from here to here is about 1.10 meter. After selecting your CAD files, go to the Modify tab and use your scale tool. Click here, click here, and press 1.1, and it will scale your work. Let me press Ctrl Z because my file unit in Revit is millimeters, so I need to input 1100. Again, select your AutoCAD file, go to the Modify tab, and use Scale tab from here. From here, click here and here, and then input the 1100. Sorry, I've pressed a wrong button, so let me change it again. Select your AutoCAD file, go to the Modify tab and use Scale tool again. From here to here is 1100 millimeter. So it's now has scaled properly. Okay, this is good for me, and you can pin it, and also you can query and explore things that we are not going to cover them in this video. For the second floor, you need to go to the level 2, and now you can see the first floor plan 2, because we haven't checked the current view only in our options when we were importing. But for the second level, click on Import CAD again and select your plan to DWG again. And now I'm not going to show this plan 2 in all of my views, so I'm going to check this box and let me put all of them in a default input. Okay, click on OK and place it everywhere you want, and then with a simple alignment, we can align our floors on top of each other. Go to the Modify tab and use Align. Let me align my A grid with A, and let me align my one grid with one. Now my plans are on top of each other properly. If you would go to the 3D, you just can't see the first one, because in the second process we check the current view only box. Okay, this is good for me, and from now on you can do anything with your CAD files, and you can model your Revit files according to these CAD files. Okay, this is nice for me. I'm not going to do anything with them. And also you can change the colors of each CAD files with pressing VG and going to the Imported Categories tab. And each file is a separate category here, and each of them has all of the layers that you have created in your CAD file. So you can change the color of CAD layers here. So you can remember the tips that I said earlier. If you would have some layers with the proper names, you can adjust them here appropriately, and it will help you to manage your CAD files in Revit 2.